Good morning and welcome to Cook for the Family with Evangelist Moya Antonia Eden. God is good all the time. We bless God for keeping us alive to see this beautiful day which He has made. We rejoice and be glad in it. We thank God for His faithfulness to us. We know that we do not make control our goals, human strength today or wisdom, but God kept us alive to see this day. We have hope because we are alive. Let us give God a clap of glory. Hallelujah. Let us bless Him for being our God, for all the good things He has done for us. Everything He's doing in our lives, even today. Let us glorify Him because there's no other God as Him. This morning, as we are called before God, let us begin to lift up the name of our God. Let us begin to praise Him for His faithfulness, for His love, for His goodness towards us. Thank Him, He is our God. We have no other God but Him. He created us for good purpose. To give Him pleasure, to serve Him, to bring souls to the kingdom, to reconcile everything He created back to Him, to bring down strongholds under the feet of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Today, thank God that we are mighty in His hands to put down the struggle of the wicked. Bless Him for your salvation. Thank you for everything you have. Thank you for the Holy Spirit that dwells in you and walks through you to perfect His will. Praise God for the Spirit and praise for us in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you for the abundant grace we have this day. The grace that gives us the power to say no to ungodliness. Thank God. He is God. Bless Him for His mercies. Bless Him for His faithfulness towards you. Bless Him for setting tables before you right in the presence of your enemies today. Thank you for anointing your heads with oil this morning. The oil of gladness is overflowing, overflowing. Bless Him that you're shining of God's peace in the mighty name of Jesus. That we show forth His praise to the world around us. That we have the love of God in us and we are able to give it to our brothers and sisters in this world. We are not those who say we love God and hate our brothers and sisters. Bless Him for what the Spirit is doing in our lives today. The Spirit is pruning us and removing everything contrary to the will of God from us. And the Spirit is making us more and more like our God every day in the name of Jesus. Thank God that we're being trained in righteousness, in godliness, that we are ascending to higher grounds in Jesus' name, in the mighty name of Jesus. Glory, hallelujah, amen. We are praising on to the high calling of God in Christ Jesus, in each one of us, in the mighty name of Jesus. And through Jesus Christ, we have strength to do all things. This morning, as I've come before God, acknowledge that He is God and He is not a God is Him. That you have not made gods out of your own human, out of your own hands, gods that cannot help you. That you have not gone to any false God to help you this morning, but you have come to the only one and true God, our Father, God Jehovah, everlasting God, greater help than I have. God who created us, God who can help us. Today we have come to Him to ask for help, to receive wisdom in the mighty name of Jesus, to be fed with the spiritual food from the Word of God this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we bless you, we thank you. You are God and God in glory. We say all the praise. There's no other God to say. From the rising of the sun to the blessed saints, your name is worthy to be praised. We are praising you this morning because of your goodness, your faithfulness, your love, Lord God, that you never fail. We thank you, Jehovah God, because we know that nothing can separate us from your love. We bless you, God. We bless you, God. We bless you, God. That not even death can separate us from your love. We thank you because you protect us every day, Father, Lord. You lead us on the path you have set for us, the righteous path, so path that leads on to salvation in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we bless you because we are heirs of your kingdom, Jehovah God, and co-heirs with Jesus Christ of everything you have created, of your kingdom, Jehovah God. Blessed be your holy name, that you made us, God, to be your light in this world, to be the salt of this world. We say thank you, Jehovah God, in the name of Jesus. We thank you that we have come before you boldly through the blood of Jesus Christ today to obtain grace and mercy to help us in our times of there is need in the families, oh Lord God. There is need, oh Lord God, in our communities, oh Lord God, in the body of Christ, in our government, oh Lord God. There is need, oh Lord God, on our jobs, oh Lord God. We need you. We need you all the time in the name of Jesus because we are constantly in the warfare against the forces of darkness in this world. And we know, Father Lord, that through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, that we overcome every plan of the wicked, Jehovah God, that you have broken this snare and you have released us, oh Lord God, and that souls have been released, oh Lord God, like birds out of the fallen snare. Jehovah God, we bless you for everything you have done for us this day. Glory, hallelujah, amen, hallelujah, amen. We know this day that you have set tables before us right in the presence of our enemies, and we are feeding on those tables, oh God. We are not afraid of what man will do unto us because we have you, our God. You are always with us. We bless you for our families, oh God, for our husbands, oh God. The husbands bless you for their wives and children, Jehovah God. We thank you because they have the fear of you in their hearts, oh God, to serve you, to worship you, to seek you in everything that they do in Jesus' name. We bless you for the family institution you created and ordained, oh God. God, we bless the family, Lord. Lord God, to be a union between a man and a woman. Father, thank you. You praise the family, Lord God, to reproduce. We thank you for the marriage institution. We bless you, God, for everything you have done, Jehovah God. Father, we thank you. We are holding on to the truth you have entrusted to each one of us, and we are passing the truth down to our children, Jehovah God, that marriage will be forever between a man and a woman, that your children will be able to reproduce and be fruitful in the mighty name of Jesus. We come against anything that is trying to violate the principles you have laid down, Jehovah God. Father, you are God. We bless you, God. We are outnumbering the children of wickedness, Jehovah God, in the name of Jesus. We thank you, God. We thank you, God. We thank you, God. The church is mighty to forward in the name of Jesus. You are positioning your children, Father God, in places of influence within the church, Jehovah God. You are speaking as your oracles in the mighty name of Jesus. Their voices are heard clearly, O Lord God, all over the world in the mighty name of Jesus. These are not the ones that are afraid about, God, of what men will do unto them. They are going to the government, O Lord God, and pointing out to the government what they are doing that are contrary to your will, so that the government will overturn those things that they have done. That oh, Rakoku will shed that and lift up, O Lord God, the truthfulness in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we are blessing you. We are thanking you for our children, O Lord God, because you are the glory and the lift up of their heads, O Lord God. We are thanking you for the great and mighty things you are doing in their lives, O Lord God. That they are responsible citizens of their families and nations and the body of Christ, O Lord God. That they are strong pillars within the church, O Lord God. We are blessing you because you prosper the work of their hands, O Lord God. They do not fall by the wayside, O Lord God. They continue to walk on that righteous path you have laid for them in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, they grow up to marry, O Lord God. Rabbi Chava have made to finish, Jehovah God, and have their children in the name of Jesus. We bless you, Father, Lord, for everything you are giving to them. You are restoring everything the enemy has tried to take from them and destroy, Jehovah God. Rabbi Chava, they belong to them, Father, Lord. The enemy cannot take anything that you are giving to our children, and we bless you because you are God. You are more than enough for each one of us in the mighty name of Jesus. We bless you for the shouts of victory and rejoicing that we hear every day within our homes, O Lord God, in our communities and our jobs, in the body of Christ, O Lord God. We are blessing you, Jehovah God, for the spirit of discernment that you have given to us this day, that we are testing every spirit that comes to find out if it is of you, Lord God Almighty. We do not open our doors, Lord God, to evil ones, Lord God, to come in. They do not come in your name, Jehovah God. We bless you for all who come in your name, Father Lord, all who lift up the banner of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We thank you for their good works, Lord God. We bless you because you are God. You multiply them on the earth, Lord God. You help them, Jehovah God, to do good works for you in the name of Jesus. We are blessing you, Jehovah God, for those that have gone up into the mission fields, Lord God. We thank you, Jehovah God, for souls that are coming to your kingdom in the mighty name of Jesus. We bless you for their good work, Lord God. We bless you, God, for those that are being persecuted, Jehovah God, because your word says they are blessed when they are persecuted for righteousness' sake, Lord God. They inherit your kingdom in the mighty name of Jesus. They are good works. We continue to speak for them in Jesus' mighty name. Father, we are blessing you, Father Lord, for those that are in chains this day, because you know your word is penetrating into those dark places of the world, O Lord God, to deliver your children from their captors in the mighty name of Jesus. We are blessing you, Jehovah God, because the chains are breaking, O Lord God. Bring the basis that have a hope of shame that you are overturning the captivity in the name of Jesus. Those that are holding their captive do not understand what is happening, but they know that it's the power of God in the name of Jesus, because they have never seen a thing like that. We are blessing you for signs and wonders that are going out into the nations, Lord God. We bless you that your word is constantly a lamp unto the feet of your children and a light unto their path in the mighty name of Jesus. We are blessing you because you are God. You are doing great and mighty things, Lord God. We are thanking you for the spirit of goodness that you are giving to the rest of us to go out into the nations to begin to proclaim this gospel of salvation, Lord God, to your children. We thank you because you are giving us instructed tongues, Lord God, the tongues of writing a writer in the name of Jesus. We thank you because grace, Lord God, is speaking to us in the mighty name of Jesus, and wisdom is leading us in the things we do in Jesus' mighty name. We thank you because you are our Father. We bless you for our husbands who have the fear of you in their hearts, Lord God. You prosper them. You bless them in the mighty name of Jesus, because they seek you in everything they do in the mighty name of Jesus. Within the church community, Father Lord, you are strong pillars, Lord God. All of them, Father Lord, are standing in their rightful positions in the mighty name of Jesus, using their spiritual gifts to bless the body in Jesus' mighty name. We thank you that within their homes, Lord God, they are pressed, Lord God. They are teaching their children and how to love you and to serve you in the mighty name of Jesus, demonstrating, Father Lord, your power every day within their families and their communities in the mighty name of Jesus. We are thanking you, Jehovah God, for their children and like all the ships around their table, Lord God, their wives are like fruitful vines within their homes in the mighty name of Jesus. We are blessing you, Jehovah God, because their wives are Admits to them in the mighty name of Jesus. That the spirit of wisdom leads their wives in the things they do in the mighty name of Jesus. We are thanking you, Jehovah God, because you bless their wives, Lord God, in the mighty name of Jesus. They nurture their children in the things of God. We are thanking you, Jehovah God, because everything, Father Lord, they seek you, Jehovah God, in the name of Jesus. They are fruitful within their homes, in their communities, and wherever they go in the mighty name of Jesus. They are active, Lord God, in ministry work within their families and in the church, in the mighty name of Jesus, in their communities, Lord God, they serve your children in the mighty name of Jesus. We are blessing you, Jehovah God, because you are leading them on the path on which they walk on. They are not idle, they are not busybodies, Lord God, but they are purposeful in the things they do in the mighty name of Jesus. We are thanking you, Jehovah God, because every day they wake up, Lord God, to the shouts of victory and rejoicing. Oh Lord God, they are filled with gladness every day and with confidence that they know that you are God in the Rabbahawa Shadda, that you order the affairs of their families and you do not fear them in the mighty name of Jesus. We are blessing you, Jehovah God, for our parents, Lord God. We are thanking you for our grandparents, for the senior citizens, for the great and mighty things they are doing in their lives, Lord God. That in old age, Lord God, they still wax strong, Lord God. They still proclaim your name, Father Lord. They still show good examples, Lord God, to the younger generations, Lord God. They testify about your faithfulness, Lord God. They are still strong watchtowers between your watchmen, between your arms, and your house in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you for the great and mighty things you are doing in their lives, Lord God. They are not being neglected in old age, Lord God. They are not being abused, Lord God, because you are compassed around them with your holy presence, Lord God. Those, Father Lord, who need medical care, Father Lord, you are taking care of them. You are healing them of their sicknesses and diseases, Lord God. We bless you, God, for the great and mighty things you are doing. Father Lord, we are blessing you for every member of our family, Lord God. We lift them up to you, Jehovah God. Anyone that has unbelief, you are touching them this day, Father Lord. You are helping them to see and to see and to understand the truth, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Because you said, if we are saved, we and every member of our families will be saved, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. We are holding on to the promise, Lord God. We are feeling on it this day because you know you will never fail us, that your word will never return to you void in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we are blessing you this day as we lift up the hospital system to you. Anyone that is sick this day, Father Lord, in our families, in the hospital, in the nursing home, Father Lord, in the rehabilitation centers, Lord God, wherever they are, Jehovah God, we pray that your spirit will over around those places like this today to touch your children in the name of Jesus. Begin to overturn every work of darkness, those that are working for Satan in those places, Lord God. Frustrate their counsel, Jehovah God. Put them down, Father Lord, that they do not prosper in anything concerning your children in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you because you are healing your children of their sicknesses and diseases. You are helping them, Jehovah God. You are God. You are speaking your word concerning them, Jehovah God. It is as you said it to be in Jesus' mighty name. We are thanking you, Jehovah God, because you are lifting up all the medical equipment, everything used, Lord God, in the care of your children, Jehovah God. We have a hope, they're all fashioned and right in the name of Jesus. You are returning every first, Father Lord, results from the test results in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we bless you. You are returning every false diagnosis of sicknesses and diseases that the children do not have. We are blessing you, Father Lord. You are positioning your children in those places, Lord God, to work for you. In Jesus' mighty name, you are giving them wisdom. You are holding their hands, Lord God, as you treat your children, Jehovah God. We are thanking you for breakthroughs, Lord God, in medical science in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, Father, as your children begin to discover the things you are putting in this world to cure cancer and the diseases, Lord God, that are ravaging your children in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, thank you for the great and mighty things you are doing. You are God. Be thou exalted in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we are blessing you at this time, O Lord God Almighty, for those that are mourning the death of loved ones. Father, you say they are blessed, they are comforted with their mourning in the name of Jesus. Jehovah God, Raka Hoshe, that we thank you, Lord God, because you have put around their great support to heaven this time, O Lord God. Difficult times of need and sorrow in the name of Jesus. Father, you are touching them and reassuring them of your love. You are touching them, Jehovah God, and reminding them that we do not live forever. In the name of Jesus, that each of us should apply wisdom to our days in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father Lord, for refreshing them in the mighty name of Jesus. So give them the strength they need in Jesus' mighty name. We bless you for the good works of their loved ones that have died and have gone into eternal rest in Jesus' mighty name. May their works speak on their behalf in Jesus' mighty name. May the blood of Jesus speak for them in Jesus' mighty name. We bless you, God, in Jesus' name, that they have entered into your rest. Jehovah God, we bless you. We thank you for those that are passing through difficult situations, Lord God. We commit it unto your hands, Lord God. Father, help them, whatever the situations are, Jehovah God. Overturn every evil and make everything beautiful in the lives of your children in the name of Jesus. We bless you, God, because you are our God. You do not leave us, Lord God, to suffer. You do not leave us in ignorance. You hear us, so we cry out to you. That's why we come to you always, to ask for wisdom, to ask for help, to bring our petitions, Lord God, to you. Oh, Father, we bless you because we know even now your spirit is praying on our behalf because we do not know how to pray or what we should pray about. Father, we bless you. You are God. In the name of Jesus, there's no other God as you. Thank you, Father. Children, thank you for the great and mighty things you are doing in their lives, Lord God, that they are growing up to become presidents of nations, Lord God. Oh, Father, that they are becoming senators and congressmen, Lord God, mayors of towns and cities in the name of Jesus, owners of their own businesses, Lord God, directors of government, Lord God, directors of private sectors, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Father, we are thank you, Jehovah God, for every good thing you are doing in their lives, Lord God. Father, you are offering around
the school system, even right now, your spirit is going in and overturning everything the enemy has put there. Father, Lord, as it's tumbling, Jehovah God, the spirit of drug addiction, you are overturning in the name of Jesus. You are delivering your children, God. We bless you for all the institutions you ordained, Lord God, the law enforcement, Lord God. We bless you because you are doing great works, Lord God. We thank you because you are overturning the work of darkness within those places, Lord God. You are positioning your children to take, to assume position of authority and to do your work there in the name of Jesus. Father, we bless you because there's a cordial relationship between the police and their communities in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you, Jehovah God, that they are going after the real terrorists, Lord God, those that are coming against your children, that they are combining forces together to bring them down in the name of Jesus. Wisdom is leading them to those places, Lord God, in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you because the communities are blessing. The communities, Lord God, are blessing law enforcement, Lord God. I'm working with them, Jehovah God, that our children are not going out to lift up your hands against them in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you for the great and mighty things you are doing in our midst, Lord God, in the Department of Corrections, Lord God. You are reviewing the cases, Lord God, of children that should not be your children that should not be there. You are releasing them, Father Lord, in the name of Jesus, Father Lord. You are bringing down every force all over whole impartial judge, Lord God, that is sitting, Lord God, on the bench, Lord God. You are bringing them there. They can't be there in the name of Jesus. Father, you are putting your children in those places. Father, we bless you for the great and mighty things you are doing in the name of Jesus. Father, we are linking out the government to you. We bless you, Lord God, because our government, Lord God, have wisdom to seek you. They are calling to you. They are listening to wisdom in the mighty name of Jesus. You are overturning the things that they did contrary to your will in Jesus' mighty name. Your children are speaking to them, those that speak as your oracles, Lord God. Spiritual fathers and leaders that do not compromise with the word. They are going and telling the government, overturn these things against the will of God. The wrath of God will come upon the nations if you do these things that you are doing contrary to the will of God. They are overturning those things. They are turning back to you in Jesus' mighty name. We bless you for their lives, Lord God, because wisdom is speaking to them in Jesus' mighty name. When they go into their own offices to have their meetings, Lord God, wisdom is right there. Oh, your children are dead, Jehovah God. They are lifting up the banner of Jesus Christ. They are not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ, Lord God. They are proclaiming the truth, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, because they understand, Father God, it's your power that gives salvation to men in the name of Jesus. For those that are perishing, Lord God, this foolishness to them in Jesus' mighty name. But we know it's all we have, and we are holding on to it in the name of Jesus. Father, within the church, we thank you for what, that because your children are rising against false prophets and teachers, Lord God, they are pulling them down in the name of Jesus. Your children are standing in the right position, Jehovah God. They are pressing back against the forces of darkness, Lord God. You are prevailing in our midst, Lord God. You are our God. We bless you for all the great and mighty things you are doing for us in the name of Jesus. Receive the praise, receive the honor in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you for spiritual fathers and leaders, Lord God, that hold on to the truth, that teach their congregation the truth, Lord God. Continue to prosper them, Jehovah God. Continue to bless their ministry. Continue to bless their families, Lord God. Continue to bless their children in the mighty name of Jesus. Continue to make them to speak as your oracles, to speak clearly and not to be afraid of the nations in the name of Jesus. Continue to use them to be in the forefront, Lord God, of everything relating to your kingdom on earth in the name of Jesus. Thank you for their good works, Lord God. We bless you, God, in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you for the spiritual blessings you have blessed us with in Christ Jesus in the heavens in the name of Jesus. Oh, Father, we thank you because you are using our spiritual gifts to bless the kingdom. We thank you, Father, because your spirit dwells in us and helps us to do your will in Jesus' mighty name. We are thanking you because we are building, oh Lord God, on the foundations you have made for us, Lord God. We are contending for our faith, Lord God. We are building on most holy faith in the mighty name of Jesus. Faith without actions, oh Lord God, is dead in the name of Jesus. We are adding action, oh Lord God, to our faith in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you because you are doing great things in our lives, oh Lord God. We bless you because we live our lives, oh Lord God, with fruitful old age in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, in the name of Jesus, you are speaking your word concerning us, Lord God. It is as you said it will be. Glory, hallelujah, amen. You are God, and there's no other God as thee. In the name of Jesus, we thank you, God. We plead the blood of Jesus this day on our sons and our nations, on our families, Lord God, on the body of Christ, Lord God, on our government, Lord God. We ask for forgiveness, Lord God. We plead the blood of Jesus on our land, Lord God. We ask for forgiveness in ways we have sinned against you, Lord God. You created us to be holy. There's no other standard through which we can have any fellowship with you, Lord God. Unless we are only in Jehovah God. Father, Lord, rule, purge, and remove from us everything contrary to your will. Strengthen us from within in the name of Jesus. Renew our minds, Lord God. Help us to be more like you in everything in the name of Jesus. Father, thank you for forgiving us of all our sins, Lord God. Because we did not hide our sins, Lord God. We have come to you this day, repenting of our sins. Coming, we have come to you as sinners, as the way we are in the name of Jesus. Father, we bless you because you do not condemn us. No one can condemn us in the name of Jesus. You have blessed us, Lord God. And our families and nations, Lord God, we thank you for the great and mighty things you are doing in our lives, Lord God. Father, this day as you have forgiven us, you have shown us mercy, Lord God. We are laying down the feet of Jesus Christ, Lord God. Every bitterness, malice, Lord God, all-forgiving spirit. Hatred, O Lord God, the spirit of Cain, anything contrary to your will, O Lord God, the spirit of jealousy and envy at the feet of Jesus Christ. You have received help today in the name of Jesus. May your will be done in our lives here on earth as it is in heaven. You are our Father, we bless you in the name of Jesus. Thank you, God. Thank you for answered prayers, O Lord God, as we go into the study of your word, spirit of the living God, enlighten our eyes, making us from within in the name of Jesus. Oh, let us feed on this word today in Jesus' mighty name. For my men shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. Let us feed on every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God today. Let the Spirit of God lead us today in the name of Jesus. Help us to say, rebuke us, discipline us. For God disciplines the children in love. God loves us. Help us to see ourselves in the light of God's word today in the name of Jesus. That each of us, each one of us, we begin to examine ourselves in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, Father, Lord, that we judge ourselves, Lord God. Oh, Father, Lord, that we turn back to you in the mighty name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, you are God. We bless you for the great and mighty things you have done for us. Thank you, God, for answered prayers in Jesus' mighty name. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Glory, hallelujah, amen. The Lord reigns, blessed be our God. May the rock of our salvation be exalted. May our God be exalted in our lives today. He is our God. Glory, hallelujah, amen. He has given us everything good today. We do not lack anything. He fights our battles and he teaches us to fight. Amen. The right hand of our God dwells fearlessly. He teaches our right hand to fight. We are pulling that stronghold today in the name of Jesus. We are trampling upon scorpions, principalities, and agents of darkness, spirit of witchcraft within families. Families outside of families, familiar spirits, and social causes and covenants taken that are contrary to the will of God, that are preventing the children of this generation from prospering, that is stagnating the destiny of anyone. We are overturning them in the mighty name of Jesus. We are holding on to the truth. We are the children of God. We believe in the power of God. Surely we shall see the goodness of God in the land of the living. We shall eat of the fat of the land, because our God is the Lord. Glory, hallelujah, amen. He is our ever, the glory and the lift up of our heads in the name of Jesus. He has prepared us for this day. He has prepared us for this day. We are showing forth his praise. We are proclaiming his goodness to the world around us, because faith comes by hearing, and it is by hearing the word of God in the name of Jesus, that we are encouraged to live for God and to do the will of God in this world in the name of Jesus. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Thank you, God, in Jesus' name, amen. Psalm 128, glory, hallelujah, amen. Blessed are all who fear the Lord, who walk in his ways. You will eat the fruit of your labor. Amen. Blessing and prosperity will be yours. Amen. Your wife will be like a fruitful vine within your house. Your sons will be like olive shoots around your table. Thus is the man blessed who fears the Lord. May the Lord bless you from Zion. Amen. All the days of your life. May you see the prosperity of Jerusalem. And may you live to see your children's children. Peace be upon Israel. Peace be upon us. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus. May we live to see our children's children according to the promise of God. May the Lord bless us from Zion this day in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus. You say, blessed is the man are all who fear the Lord. Everyone, the man, the woman, the children, all who fear the Lord, they are all blessed. Because we walk in his ways. Amen. That we eat the fruit of our labor. We will not wake up to eat the bread of sorrow. God has provided all our needs today. We will eat the fruit of our labor in the name of Jesus. That blessings and prosperity will be ours in Jesus' mighty name. For the man, his wife will be like a fruitful vine within his house. Glory, hallelujah, amen. That his sons will be like olive shoots around his table. Amen. That thus is the man, that's the way God blesses that man that fears him. Amen. Glory, hallelujah, amen. The Lord has blessed us this morning. Amen. We will live to see the prosperity of Jerusalem. All the days of our lives will be blessed. Amen. Glory, hallelujah, amen. And we live to see our children's children in the name of Jesus. Peace of the Lord. The peace of the Lord is upon us and our families and nations in the name of Jesus. Glory, hallelujah, amen. We feed on the promises of God today. It's for us. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Glory, hallelujah, amen. This morning, we want to continue the study of the book of Genesis. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Chapter 14. We read a few verses this morning. Glory. Abram rescues Lot. We remember that when Abram and his nephew Lot separated, Lot went to the plains, the east plains, amen, or the eastern plains, amen, close to Sodom and Gomorrah, amen. And the word of God states that that path where he went to, that the people who lived there, amen, were very wicked, amen, that every day, constantly, they sinned against God, amen. Today we are going to read that about Adam, that Abraham rescues Lot, amen. We may not be able to take the entire passage, but we are going to read, I have like 10 to verse 7 this morning, and we continue. Glory, hallelujah, amen. When you dwell close to wicked people, your soul will be grieved, amen. Especially if you are a righteous person, amen. When you see the things that they do, amen. So, it happened to Abraham. Glory to Lot in the name of Jesus. And he had to be rescued, amen. The wickedness of the evil ones, amen, does not just, they extend it to the people around them, amen. Because that's all they know how to do. To them, wickedness is a game in the name of Jesus. We pray that God rescue us from every evil today in our communities, wherever we go, in the mighty name of Jesus. That the Spirit of God will lead us to walk on that path that God has laid for us, in the name of Jesus. That the lust of the eyes will not make us to embrace things and to rush to places that we should not be, in the name of Jesus. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Genesis 14. At this time, Amraphel, king of Shinar, I believe that's the name, king of Shinar, Arioch, king of Ellasar, Kedorlaomer, king of Elam and Tidal, king of Goyim, went to war against Bera, king of Sodom, yeah. Birsha, king of Gomorrah, Shinab, king of Admah, Shemeber, king of Zeboyim, and the king of Bela joined forces in the Valley of Siddim, the subsea. For 12 years, they had been subject to Kedorlaomer, but in the 13th year, they rebelled. In the 14th year, Kedorlaomer and the kings allied with him went out and defeated the Rephaites in Ashteroth Karnaim, the Zuzites in Ham, the Emites in Shaveh Kiriathaim, and the Horites in the E country of Seir, as far as Paran, near the desert. Then they turned back and went to En Mishpat, that is Kadesh, and they conquered the whole territory of the Amalekites, as well as the Amorites, who were living in Hazezon Tamar. Amen. I'll continue a little. Then the king of Sodom and the king of Gomorrah, the king of Admah, and the king of Zeboyim, and the king of Bela, that is Zoar, marched out and drew up their battle lines in the Valley of Siddim against Kedorlaomer, king of Elam. Amen. Tidal, king of Gom, Amraphel, king of Shinar, and Arioch, king of Ellasar. Four kings against five. Now the Valley of Siddim, amen, was full of tar pits, And when the kings of Sodom and Gomorrah fled, some of the men fell into them, and the rest fled to the hills. The four kings seized all the goods of Sodom and Gomorrah, and all their food. Then they went away. Then they also carried off Abram's nephew Lot and his possessions, since he was living in Sodom. Glory, hallelujah, amen. We stop today, verse 12. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Where the peace of God is not, there's constant striving. Amen. People fight. They hate one another because there's no peace. Already, we know that these people, as word of God states about concerning them, that states concerning them that they were very wicked generation that constantly sinned against God. Amen. We know the way God works, but we do not know. I'll put it, we know the way God works, but we do not know the full extent of the wisdom of God. Amen. Glory. Hallelujah. Amen. That God, in his own wisdom, might and power, can turn a people united for evil purpose against one another. That they begin to fight themselves and use their own sword to attack themselves in the mighty name of Jesus. These people were living together. They were all doing evil things. They did not have any consciousness of what was good. They did not acknowledge God. They were just doing their own things. Constantly, they grieved God. But today, we are reading that they came against one another. Four kings against five. Amen. They were all subject to one king for a long time, for 12 or 13 years. 12 years or so. But in the 13th year, they rebelled against him. That for 12 years, they have been subject to Kedorlaomer. But in the 13th year, they rebelled against him. For 12 years, they were one under this one key, King Kedorlaomer. They obeyed him, they followed him, they did the same thing together. But we can see in everything the power of God to divide these evil people. Amen. To show that he sees God in the affairs of men. That in the what went wrong, if for 12 years they were with him, amen, working with this evil king, all of them, the same spirit in each one of them. But in the 14th year, amen, but in the 13th year, they rebelled. Then in the 14th year, Kedorlaomer and the kings allied with him went out and defeated the Rephaites in Ashteroth, and they went out and they defeated some of the nations around them. Amen. And they continued, they joined forces together. They went against Sodom and Gomorrah. And Sodom and Gomorrah and the four kings also that were with them came also to fight. But however, they were defeated. Amen. Because Sodom and Gomorrah were very evil nations. Amen. Constantly sinned against God in their ways, in the mighty name of Jesus. They were defeated in the name of Jesus. Now the four kings seized all the goods of Sodom and Gomorrah and all their food. Four kings came against five kings, and the four kings defeated the five kings that were on the side of Sodom and Gomorrah, that allied with Sodom and Gomorrah. Then that the four kings seized all the goods of Sodom and Gomorrah and all their food. Then they went away. They seized everything and then they went away. They also carried off Abram's nephew, Lot, and his possessions, since he was living in Sodom. Adam's nephew was living there, he was carried away too, because the four kings overpowered that nation, those nations, and carried away their possession along with Lot. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Glory, hallelujah, amen. This morning we are going to thank God, the God of all wisdom, the God who can scatter those that are united together for evil purpose in the mighty name of Jesus, so that his will concerning the nations will prevail in Jesus' mighty name. Wherever people have come together for evil today, let the Spirit of God come against them. Let them be scattered. Let them fall down into the pit they have dug for the children of God. Let them begin to use their own hands to fight one another. The words they have spoken out of their proud mouths to attack the children of God, let these words return back to their heads in the name of Jesus. Let them be scattered and confused in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, as you're praying this night, people are coming together. They are in case, Lord God. They are around the world. They are planning. They're planning to bring, Father Lord, oh, Father Lord, terror upon the nations, Jehovah God. They are planning evil. Oh, Father Lord, in the name of Jesus, Father, you created us. You created the world. You created the world. Yeah, Father Lord, even those that are planning today, Father, you are calling the affairs of men. Arise, O Lord God, and let your enemies be scattered. Let them use their minds to begin to find themselves, O Lord God. Let them be scattered. Prevail in the matters of your children, Jehovah God. Keep us safe as we go about our business, Jehovah God. We have no other God but you. We bless you, God. We surrender under your authority this day. In the name of Jesus, we thank you, God, for what your Spirit is doing to do trust, Lord God, and in us, Lord God, to perfect your will on earth. In the name of Jesus, we say the praises to the honor this day. In Jesus' mighty and precious name, we have prayed. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Praise the Lord, hallelujah, amen. The Lord grant it. Blessed be our God, may the rock of our salvation be exalted. May our God be exalted in each of our lives today. In the name of Jesus, God loves us. Let us proclaim the love of God to the people around us and begin to testify about the faithfulness of our God, about the gospel of salvation to the nations. Glory, hallelujah, amen. We love you. We bless this day. Glory, hallelujah.